What's happening, Toon Squad? It's the big homie Toons, and I'm about to play Blues and Bullets. Now this is an episodic game. I haven't played it at all. It's first time playing it. I decided that I would record it and post it. It was $5 for the episode. For this episode, I guess. And I guess you gotta pay for the rest. Like it reminds me of The Walking Dead. I played the whole Walking Dead series over on 360. I definitely didn't buy it on Xbox One because I already played the shit and beat it. Only reason, you know, anybody. And don't say, oh man, you bought GTA though. The only reason I did that because that's the next level. Oh shit, this shit look clean though. That's that A button. It's the truth. Where they go? Where they go at? Set my brightness. Oh man, this shit look good. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it right there. Where is that? Oh, you want me to do something anyway, though? Nah, she good right there. Okay, I guess I gotta hit back. Okay. Alright, I am tuned with the boy over there. Look at that rain dripping off the screen, though. That shit ain't sexy to y'all. That shit ain't sexy to y'all. Oh, yeah, this definitely looks like Walking Dead. Because it got a little drugs like. Alright. Hopefully this shit clean though. Let's see if it's clean or not. Also y'all might hear my dogs in the background and shit. Yeah, man, they run free. They run free, nigga. Born free as the wind. Butterfly.
Butterfly in the sky.
Oh man, I like that. The words in the I like that. Ooh. Oh, what this? What's going on here? Somebody screaming and shit. Look kind of scary down here. Now this is scary, man. I don't know, cause I'll be like, ooh. Damn, this shit kinda dark. Oh shit. What's that? Oh shit! Is that the devil, nigga? Oh shit. Get me out of here. There we go. Get me out of here. One person did the voice acting? It's a talented motherfucker.
Hey, hell yeah, he's talented as hell, man. You don't want to go in that room. Don't go in that room, bitch.
I should do a whole video of like slow-mo plays. Some slow-mo plays. Pimp Toon plays. Everybody fighting in the background, man. I'm young. I'm gonna try to take it out. My turn. Oh shit, I'm playing with a little bit. Oh shit. I'm trying to escape from the cell. Oh, she crying like shit. Look at the little red shoes though. Nigga, we booling.
Get me out of here, please.
Alright man, chill. I got you, cuz. Alright, blood. Now look at this over here, blood. What you got right here? That's probably where they take a shit at. Was that toilet paper? Yeah, that's where they take a shit at. Alright, blood. Hold on, let me look over here real quick, blood. Damn, she's scared. Oh, is how long she been in there? I'm guessing because she don't talk or nothing. They don't tell you nothing.
If we don't escape, I'll be punished. I've been bad.
You been bad? What you do, bud? You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be confident out here. You know what I mean? I want him to keep.
Okay. What if we're caught?
Hey, listen. We ain't gonna get caught.
You see? One down. That just leaves yours and the one on the door. I'll be punished. I've been bad. I'll be punished.
It's okay. What is he doing, be man? Quiet. He is being bad. He out here tripping a little bit. What do you mean, what?
Just look out, okay?
Just look out for a real nigga real quick. Alright, let me get out here and unlock your shit. You already know something about to pop off, yo. Can't be sexy out here. Can't run in the, oh shit! Get back in your shit.
Quick, get me out of here. Be quiet.
Oh my god, I can't run faster. Bitch, you. Oh shit.
What are
oh,
you
in
doing?
Jesus' name.
Help me,
in Jesus'
please.
Name, I should have went back.
There isn't time to open both locks.
Oh god, I should have went back.
Quick.
Boys, cage, exit. Let me get out of here.
What are you doing? Help me, please.
My bad, cuz. I had to get out of here, man. I gotta fuck with my. I gotta go for
no.
my.
I'm gonna be punished.
They ain't gonna punish you that bad, man. Just take that ass whooping like a man. Oh, shit. So I gotta go back and get his. Oh, I gotta hide. Oh, shit. I suppose they got his lock. See? Fucking up already, yo. Oh, that's the devil, bro. That is the devil. Maybe he'll spare him for a second. Now let me. Oh, he's getting fucked up.
There.
Oh, you snitching ass. You snitching ass
she's
nigga.
Been really bad, hasn't she?
You snitching ass nigga. So it's about to be game over for me, huh? Oh, shit. That snitching ass nigga. About to go off. Snitching ass nigga. She's been bad.
Fuck you.
Captive. I got captured. I definitely hope somebody else play it. So I can see what the fuck. Damn, that shit took forever to load. Her red shoe disappeared. You know where they at? They out there shooting people.
Yeah.
Elliot?
Just a second. Alice, I thought you were on the day shift. Pie?
Well, I just slipped out for a second. This arrived for you at the station.
Thanks. I'll put it in the back room, then I'll get you a slice of pie. Deal?
I'm kind of in a hurry.
Yeah, she ain't asked for no pie.
What kind?
Blueberry.
It's a deal.
Put the check on the sheesh!
It's not much, but I earned it.
Of course you did. Going young. Definitely got time to sit down. I'm supposed to be making her a pie. Only can't touch us. Touchables. Mafia. Oh man, Mafia going at it, huh? Al Capone. Tax evasion. Of course. Of course. You got to. He's a gangster.
Hey, Ness! Where's my burger?
Oh, shit.
God damn it, Ness! You gotta be the slowest waiter in Santa Esperanza.
I guess so. The girls at Happy Doll say you're more of the speedy type. I won't keep you waiting again.
Anyway, they catch the deadbeat robbing the pharmacy, but there's no proof,
so they
hand him over to me.
Elliot, seriously, I don't have much time.
Damn, bitch, you better call him the fuck now. Shit. You ain't even paid for this shit. You could've get the fuck out of here. Talking to me like that. The fuck is your problem?
Take your time. If Jenkins says anything, tell him it's my fault. And let him know that I'll continue to keep his agents waiting until he settles his tab.
I don't think I dare. But this is worth getting in trouble for.
To think, I didn't find my true calling until I was in my 50s.
Gotta prepare this dude's order.
And this time, go easy on the chili sauce. Gives me indigestion.
More sauce.
Done.
That's enough.
Okay, tell him, if you confess right now, I finish work on time and everybody's happy. If you don't, I have to work late. I get mad, and I have to rearrange your face.
This man,
you really said that?
There you go.
And listen to this, Ness. And then I say to him, the doctor will have to work late too, and it'll be your fault. He'll be mad. And when he's done fixing your mug, it'll be so ugly, you'll never get laid again.
He's saying, right?
Yeah, like a soprano. And you know what I did next, Ness?
He went to celebrate at Happy Dolls. 10 minutes later, you walked out of there.
Yeah, what the hell do you know? Anyway, the important part is I rearranged the guy's face. How much sauce did you put on this thing, you goddamn maniac?
I only put 2 squirts.
Just enough to make sure you never come back here, Dickinson.
screw you, Ness.
Suspicious, huh? This dude walk. Everybody walks slow as shit, man.
Your first time here, right? I like this job, you know? Not because I like serving coffee or food. This job is about understanding people, knowing what they want.
Man, you don't want to hear that shit.
You just have to keep your eyes open. The clothes, the haircut, a little movement, a hand clutching a knife. Don't even think about it. Not because of me. At most, I'd knock out a couple of your teeth before disarming you. The guys you should be worried about are the cops at the other table. They'd keep kicking you in the ribs long after you passed out. You'd be lucky to wake up in a hospital. The question is, what do I do with you now?
I'm gonna give him some severity, man.
I don't care how you screw up your life, but I like this job and I can't afford trouble. So beat it. Now. And if you come back here looking for trouble, you'll find it.
You hear me, bitch? Damn, bitch, you ain't got nowhere on that
coffee?
Pot.
I forgot to thank you for bringing my pension check.
Well, I saved you a trip.
Yes,
and a headache.
You did.
The station's full of Dickinsons. Your dad would be proud of you.
Thanks. They're not Jenkins.
Easy there, miss. Slow and steady wins the race. If I don't get some blackberry pie this minute, I'm gonna die before this day is out. Can you help me, sir?
You won't know.
I'm afraid not.
That's too bad. I need something sweet for my last day on Earth.
I want some cornbread.
Last slice.
You use almond extract?
Quarter of a teaspoon.
Which brand?
I make my own.
Make your own.
Do I know you from someplace?
Me? No. my boss.
A little stale. A little stale. Oh, okay, I see what's going on. Damn, 20 years ago. So that shit, this dude, like. Red Nation out here, ain't it?
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Sleep at home. Oh, shit.
Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Am I getting the whip, though? And getting the whip.
Yeah, Garrison, O'Reilly, DiPietro, Dockers.
Walking out of the middle of the street, snowy as shit out here.
Garrison, O'Reilly,
blooded
DiPietro,
up.
Dockers.
You know what I'm saying?
You, call your boss. I have business to settle with him.
Oh, shit.
Can't even enjoy a quiet smoke. Look, I get it. It's Christmas. You're lonely and you want to end it all. But Santa Esperanza is full of bridges. Why not throw yourself off one of them and leave me in peace?
Tell Capone that Elliot Ness is here.
Elliot Ness. Oh, yo, I remember Elliot Ness.
Jeez.
Yeah, none of that shit is making sense.
Enough.
That's
listen,
crazy. I've
you got
heard
it backwards.
A couple times.
I'm not here to make my boss come out. I'm here to stop you getting in.
Yo, fuck that, yo.
I hope you ask
get up
Santa
in this
Claus
shit.
For crutches, because if you don't do what I say, they're going to be the perfect gift for you.
Maybe I could borrow a pair from your buddy, Dockers. I hear he's never going to need them again.
Oh, shit, he killed your boy.
You shouldn't have brought that up.
Busted
oh,
shit.
No? You going to cry now? Hey, come on. It's Christmas.
It's Christmas. Just drop this. Woo! Punch him in. Goddamn, punch him through the goddamn fence. That fence is weak as shit. Oh, shit. Oh, the bus.
It's Ness!
It's Elliot Ness, nigga.
Put down your weapons. You'll get a fair trial.
Oh, shit. Elliot Ness. Oh, shit. Oh, okay. Fuck him! Bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. To the gate. Oh, shit. Stay right there, baby. He got a Tommy over there. I'm gonna stay right here. Woo! Goddamn, how are you hitting him? There we go.
You're dead.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Get you some cover, boy. Get some cover. I'm gonna take out the dude on the roof. Just gonna squeeze. Squeeze. Ooh! Couldn't get in there. Couldn't get. Got his ass, though. Woo! Damn! You almost got me, boy. He's coming out next. Woo! Oh! This nigga had to reach. I was about to squeeze. Oh! What's that back there? Got him! Boy, they're hitting the Quan, won't it? Oh, there's some more shit over there. I see y'all. Sheesh! Oh! Shit, somebody
we need more man!
What?
Got him! Come here, boy. Come here, boy. Give me that shit!
He's mine.
He ain't fucking with me, nigga. Oh, shit. Damn, how the fuck I ain't hitting this nigga? There we go. Ah. You kidding me? What else on that? I seen you.
You niggas ain't fucking with me.
Oh! Oh! Word, you still on the deal? Get your ass out of here. Oh, shit. Cut that shit out, nigga. It's crazy, man. You was tucking the shit like a G, though. Come on, stand up, bitch. Oh, what's that back up? Oh, it's a snowman. I don't know what this is down here. Is that part of this guy that keeps standing up? Yep. Sorry about that, sir. You did? Yeah, you did. Inside now. All right, here we go. It's probably the final part, man. Go see Capone. I'm drunk. Still drunk. That's how you take care of business. Drunk. Schmug motherfucker. You ain't listening to good music, huh? She ain't got no Kanye, though. Should've went around in a circle. 2K style. Yo, don't even say nothing. Just shoot his ass.
Have any last words?
You come into my house?
Oh, shit. Al Capone trip.
You destroyed my family.
You kill my men.
I didn't know human beings mattered to you.
Would you kill an unarmed man? You? Elliot Ness?
Yep. Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
That Elliot Ness is dead. You killed him yourself.
Papa. Pull that trigger. Oh, shit.
Antonio. Are you gonna kill me in front of my son?
See, he got booked for tax evasion, so I figured I
wasn't that stain right there is all that's left of D'Annunzio, one of my best men. I told him to take care of the butcher on East Main, one of the jerks who've been screwing with me for months. We had to make an example of him. Send a message to the other storekeepers. D'Annunzio ripped out his guts and hung him up with the merchandise, but he did it while the butcher's daughter was watching. Fucking D'Annunzio. There are lines that cannot be crossed. We have to protect the innocence of children. Keep them far, far away from certain experiences.
Your son should know what kind of monster his father is. I can't think of a better life lesson.
Look,
bust his shit.
His hand's shaking.
I'm drunk, that's why. Booze
turns men into cowards. You'll be like your father. Never drink. It's funny, huh? The White Knight of the Volstead Act gets liquored up to kill the king of bootleg booze.
Yo, go out in fury, bro.
Relax, son. Nobody's going to kill anybody. I'd love to introduce you to a girl your age, Vittorio. Her name is Claire Dockers, and she sings like an angel. You two would get along. 2 days ago, Claire's father caught up with yours in a warehouse. Your father was hitting innocent people, and that's not right. He told him to stop, but your father ignored him and pulled out a gun to shoot him. Claire's father was quicker. He drew his gun first and fired, but the bullet jammed. Your father killed Claire's father in cold blood. He kicked him in the face so many times, not even Claire herself would have recognized him.
Damn.
You'll never prove I killed Dockers.
I know. And that's why I'm here. But now I know I'm better than you. Your father
I'm
is
not,
a murderer.
Though. I told you
and
to
Claire
kill him.
Hasn't stopped crying these last 2 days, all because of him. Never forget that, Vittorio.
Hold it! Let him go. Run, Ness! and forget I exist, or I'll have to report what you just did. And I do have witnesses. You hear me, Ness?
You hear me, Ness?
Yous do's what you wants to do's. I don't know why they talk like that back then. Back to the present.
That's some first-class pie. Appreciate it. Thank you, sir. My car is parked outside. If you could join me as soon as possible, I'll be doubly grateful.
Gentlemen, I'm closing up. Time to move along.
So early? What are you talking about, Ness?
Are you serious? Get the fuck out of here, you fat motherfucker.
I said get out.
Hey, fuck you, Ness. I'm not paying you a cent. You just lost a customer.
I don't give a fuck.
But just think what I gain in quality of life.
But this fat Pillsbury dope boy having that motherfucker than you talking to anyway, old fuckhead ass, bitch ass, sausage eating ass motherfucker. What was this?
And that's how a bullet turns into a boomerang.
Put my shit on, you know what I'm saying? Swoop. You know what I mean? About to grab me a burger or something before I walk out, though. Probably gonna be hungry and shit. This girl just kills his family and flees. Goddamn.
Goddamn, goddamn.
Alright, shit. What the hell was that? I had to sink into that shit. I ain't give a fuck about that shit, bro. I think you really find shit in this game. How's that shit broke? How the fuck is that? Fuck that, man. I ain't looking at shit. How's that shit broke, though? Like, this your diner, man. This nigga walks slow as fuck, yo. Look at this real quick before I walk out. Oh, this is some children and shit. Man. That jukebox. They ain't got no future up there. I don't want to hear it.
I blew a bag today.
Alright. Alright, damn, my nigga walks close.
At last, Mr. Ness. Please get in.
How do I know this isn't a trap?
How do I know you can be trusted? You just kicked your customers out in the middle of their meal. Please get in. I can't afford for you to catch a cold.
Shh. Because you told me to come with you. What you mean? Never follow a stranger. Whoa, he just got in anyway? Bruh. Oh, I should have did identity. That's what I should have did. And he asked who he was. Dang. That rain, though. That rain. Oh, shit. I thought I just looked at some joint where it said he was locked up. This is it. It's Red Nation in here. Everybody, blood game, huh? Swoop.
We'll be going up in a couple of minutes. I'll wait for you in the cable car.
Going up, and ain't up even where? A Tuesday, son. You won't even tell me where we going, huh? Get to the cable car. My nigga, why you just gonna leave and shit, though? Where you go? He went around and said, they don't let you go that way. Like, there's nothing really over here, so you gotta go around this huge circle. So we can show you the ambiance. That's how a lot of shit be, though. They want you to, games, like this whole spot right here, probably gonna be in here for about 2-3 minutes. Probably took them a whole year to make this animation, but whoa, let me get out your way, dog. You drunk? Drunk as fuck, man.
Man, fuck that picture, man. She ain't teaching me shit. Play with it. I might need to know who the fuck that is, though. Nah, that shit go.
A. Ryan, owner of Ryan Hotels.
I figured I'd
know
who
transformed the Hindenburg into the monument to aeronautical luxury it is today.
Alright.
Damn! This old ass man walking this slow, bruh. Can't get out into a brisk jog or nothing. Look at John Coffey over there.
Okay, let's go.
Bro, you gonna tell me who you are, man?
Scared of heights?
Hell no.
Hey, you sure we don't know each other?
I never lie, sir. If you need a paper bag, I have one.
Oh, so yeah. He did say, admit it.
How high does this thing go?
So he's afraid of heights.
Higher than the clouds.
Higher than the clouds, nigga. Damn. Onto a blimp. This dude got too much money, don't he? What they had that on GTA? The apartment in a blimp. The loading is real in this game. Jesus. This shit nice. Go to the reception desk. So I am this bitch paid in the shade,
I'm afraid I can't come with you. Thanks for the pie.
But...
Welcome to the Grand Hindenburg Hotel. My name is Susan, and I'm glad to be of service. Your name, please?
Elliot Ness. Real name, you know who they're looking for.
Elliot Ness.
Thank you, Mr. Ness. Nice choice. Sounds genuine. And now, how can I help you?
I'm here to see Mr. Capone.
There's no Mr. Capone here, Mr. Ness.
Who the fuck am I looking for?
Listen, Susan. I don't know if he signed in as Mr. Capone, Mr. Scarface, or Satan himself, but I know he's here. And now you're going to tell me which room he's in, or you're going to have a problem on your hands.
Bitch.
He's in the presidential suite. Top floor at the end of the red carpet.
Thank you, Susan.
That was easy.
Have a pleasant stay at the Grand Hindenburg Hotel, Mr. Ness.
Shit, I should have gave a false name then. I probably ain't gonna be able to get it though.
Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 3 minutes.
Oh, shit. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to get on that bitch, huh? What are we looking at? Looking at that view, huh? That bitch clean!
Higher than the clouds.
That's how Kush be getting. Kush be getting higher than the clouds. Damn, this motherfucker walks slow as hell. Oh, that dude just left? Shit. Bruh, you can't run or nothing.
Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 2 minutes.
Damn, I got time? I probably shouldn't have looked at that view. She said upstairs on the left, didn't she? Oh, it's only gonna let me go a certain way anyway. I seen that. Is you right? Nah, it's looking out. I ain't got time to look at that.
You know, the views and shit. We got here. Oh, shit. Oh. Is that bitch naked? No, she ain't naked. It's pointing me out here.
Looking at the scenery, baby. Ooh wee, baby, yeah, photo booth, baby, photo booth, baby. Ooh. Sorry, when I don't want to hear like music or something, I just start singing over it.
Damn. Come on.
What the fuck? What's your problem, man? This dude got some issues, bruh. He got some issues, baby. He got some issues, baby. He got some issues. Oh, shit. Somebody in there getting deep, ain't he? Somebody here getting deep. Let the red pumps outside. Do not disturb. Just married. Oh, my bad. I ain't gonna come in there. Do your thing. Do your thug thizzle. I don't think I went the wrong way, baby. I don't think I went the wrong way. Oh man, I thought it was about to load. I was about to say that load about to be real. Dang! Getting his janitor swag on. Somebody out here chilling, man. Red leaves and shit. I told y'all, man, it's Red Nation out here. A lot of shit ain't even fucking with, you know what I'm saying? That like a real picture. I'm pretty sure that is a real picture. King of Knives. Oh yeah, no. Oh shit, he just here. Shit ain't moving that fast though. Speed that motherfucker up. God damn it.
Oh. Bravo.
Yikes! Holy shit!
Humpbacks will know the name of it. Oh, no, he just did it. Sad.
I'm sorry.
What the fuck? I just want to say something. See, man, that's what I shouldn't have won. That did absolutely nothing for the story. I should have just kept walking.
The man didn't say nothing. It's that white privilege, ain't it? Say you are supposed to be here.
If it wasn't for my habit of checking all possible exits when I walk into the lion's den, I'd be a dead man.
So this is my exit. Stairs. Get stairs.
Oh, god damn!
You should be rotting in jail.
That's exactly what I've been doing for the last 19 and a half years. You'll be surprised what a little good behavior can do for a person. You're not gonna ask me for my last words this time. I'm a lot closer to death than when I last saw you.
Get them right to you, your old ass.
As are you.
Why did you ask me here?
Why did you come?
I wanted to see if you'd improved with age. I'm glad to see the answer's no.
When you said rot in jail, you really meant it, huh? Look, I didn't ask you here to find out who's got the snappiest comebacks. I want to hire you.
You on that Fetty Wap, ain't you?
What?
I require your services as a detective.
I don't know what your game is, But if your plan was to surprise me, you've succeeded.
Look, Ness. My granddaughter Sophia has been kidnapped. Happened to my son, Vittorio, I put her in a boarding school. She was entered under a false surname, Colombo. Nobody knows who she is.
Nobody?
Only Milton, the man who brought you here. I trust him completely. 2 days ago, a guy turned up at the boarding school. He introduced himself as Guido Colombo, girl's uncle, and her new legal guardian. He said her parents had just died in a tragic automobile accident. He produced all the relevant papers, driver's license, the custody document supposedly made out by the father, the death certificates. He explained away the fact that the girl didn't know him by saying he moved to Seattle before she was born.
Any clues?
Sophia was wearing a blue dress with flowers that I personally ordered for her from Italy. She was also wearing white ballet shoes with daisies embroidered on them.
Damn, he looked like he did.
As for the guy, the school principal said he was tall and slim, in his 50s. No particular accent. Black hair, no beard, no glasses.
No beard.
Dressed. Could be anyone. But I know he was hired by one of my old associates. Someone wants to finish me once and for all. Maybe they want control of what's left of my organization. Maybe they hate my guts.
And I thought I was the only one who still hated you after 20 years. What else have you got?
I got this. And I got you.
You don't have me. My place is at my diner. And your girl's not there.
Huh. So where should I be looking?
You were the biggest boss in the Mafia. And by the looks of this place, you didn't lose everything. Why don't you ask one of your subordinates for help?
You don't listen, do you? The kidnapper was hired by one of my men. One of the people I trust.
No, I heard you.
So why me?
I heard you.
20 years ago, I pushed you to the edge. I bought your friends and killed the ones who couldn't be bought. I got you so obsessed with me that your wife ended up leaving you. When you had nothing left, you walked into my house, shot my bodyguards, and pointed a gun at me. You could have killed me. But you chose to take it out on this piano. You're the only honest man I know.
I'll do it. Not for you. For her.
I knew I got the right guy.
I ain't feel like egging him on, man. Because he's obviously got to do it, obviously.
Ask. I won't haggle.
That's the fucking story. Nation jail, exile.
You give your entire fortune to the Santa Esperanza Hospice.
That won't be difficult. I've been donating to them for decades. And I don't need the money anymore. I don't give a damn what happens to me, Ness. You just saved Sophia.
Made a choice.
And you can start by investigating
Carlo Boccherini.
How did you know?
Biggest forger in Santa Esperanza. Wouldn't surprise me if Sophia's so-called uncle's papers were made by him. Besides, he's been cursing your name ever since we put you in jail.
Hey, I treated him like a son.
After you killed his parents.
Damn.
They were selling booze without my permission.
Damn.
You know where to find him?
I have a good contact at the station. A girl. Rookie. Straight arrow.
Reliable.
A girl?
You saying you trust her?
You are such a chauvinist. Do you trust me?
Deal? That's a spirit.
Said punch him. I should have punched him. I'm sure it would have been a deal
keep
anyway.
Milton informed at all times, huh? You hear me?
I should have punched.
I know you from somewhere.
Fucking Green Mile, bro. He was in the Green Mile. Ah, that movie ain't came out yet, ass.
Yo, you're not gonna ask me for my last words.
You should be running. I'm never going to help you.
Why me? I'm not asking you to help me.
I'm not a cop. I'll do it. Not for you.
Woo! Let's go through this. I think I seen this little part on Twitch. Woo! That shit clean! Alright, so if y'all liked the video, man, hit the like button. If you didn't, yo, I'm sorry. I was just planning. I might as well upload it because I sat here and recorded it. NBA Live 16 comes out next week on the little demo joint, so I'm going to be uploading that at 2K in a couple days, man. I mean, damn. And 2K, you know, that's going to be out on the 25th. So you're definitely going to see that. Oh. Oh, yeah. No, sir. No. Ooh, this shit clean. This shit clean, boy. Come on. Shut up. Reload. Damn it. Ah. Shit. Come out of there. Stay out of there. Get out. Back, I say. Back. Ooh, shit! Red Nation.
Rebuilt my life. Got my feet back on the ground.
That wasn't even an intro. The outro. Banging. Dragged me in. Woo! That shit clean! Y'all can't tell me that shit ain't clean, man.
I'm gonna need help.
This episode about to be over. Yo, give me that whiskey. Fuck you mean? I drink no goddamn juice. Drink that juice inside this whiskey. Pull that shit up. Pull up. Drink. Oh, shit. Yo, hold up. Get this drink first, man. Fuck that. Don't waste that drink. That was a choice that I made. A choice. Like, you decided to drink. Am I drunk? Too drunk to talk?
I knew you would, Alice.
Write this down. 31 Wicker Avenue in Lakeview.
Thanks. Nice work.
Elliot, what do you want with him? He's got a hell of a file.
Oh, I just want to, you know what I'm saying,
Right now, it's better you don't know, Alice.
What? Are you protecting me?
I promised your father that I would.
I'm a cop, not a little girl.
Alice, I don't have much time. I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks.
I've been working this late shift. Pull up. Drink. Headshot. Drink. 52 minutes. Old enemy. The third chapter, episode one. How many chapters is it? Shit. Buy me a spaceship and fly past the sky. I wanna take
31 Wicker Avenue. This is it.
This shit long, bro.
Sure.
I'm sure.
At last. That stench of stale grease about you reminds me too much of my old job.
You worked as a waiter?
I was a chef, and not in any old kitchen, at the maximum security penitentiary on Gore Island. Can't think of a better way to do time.
That dog just sitting in the road.
I think I met Alphonse playing
shit
golf.
Lego would do.
Alphonse.
On the subject of cooking, I know your blueberry pie had an extra something. I still don't know what.
Hennessy.
Alphonse.
So what now? You got a plan?
Oh, this stuff.
Take a look around.
He ran that red light, then he got what the fuck? Door.
My pleasure.
He just ran the other one too. Like disappeared or something. God, what the fuck is going on in this? Look at him. He jogging. Why I can't? Yeah. Dang. This nigga walking like an old lady, yo.
The fact that a criminal like him can hang up his shingle in broad daylight says a lot about Santa Esperanza.
Where'd he go? Like, runs up here. I don't need to look at none of that shit. I don't need to look at it. It don't mean nothing to me. He got a garden gnome. Big whoopty fucking dude. Man, get your ass in. You don't want to ring that bell, though.
You can ring my
bell. The bell doesn't work. I guess Baccarini doesn't have any visitors.
Motherfucker. Knock on that shit. Let's go gentle first.
Baccarini?
Ah, shit.
Carlo Baccarini?
Nothing of interest out back. Sorry.
That motherfucker swole as shit. His arms don't even go. Ness.
What is it?
He in there?
I don't know how to describe it.
You mean he dead in there? He did in there, ain't he? What I just see? Get that motherfucking dough in. Oh, shit!
Is that our man?
Baccarini.
Damn, my somebody God. Fucked him up.
We have to find out who did this.
Fucking devil did that, yo.
Let's go.
You're the detective, Mr. Ness. Besides, Alfonso want to see this. I'll be right back.
All right.
Damn, man, I know it's stinking.
We have to establish how Baccarini died. Maybe the body parts can shed some light on the motive.
Got it. Oh, shit. Got a little investigation joint. Alright.
Holy Christ. What the hell are we up against?
Yeah, man. I told you, man. That's the devil, cuz.
His eyes were pulled clean out of their sockets. Whoever did this, it wasn't their first time. And if they committed any other murders like this... It's likely that the police found some of the bodies.
Damn, bro.
I must remember to ask Alice.
That's why you gotta keep a gun, yo.
His teeth were all pulled out before he was killed.
Damn!
The buildup of blood inside his mouth speaks for itself.
New clue, got some fingerprints? I gotta move like this. Damn.
This isn't a cut, it's a tear.
Shit.
His hands were ripped off.
Damn!
Who has that kind of strength?
The devil, I told you. God damn, ripped his shit off like that? What else we got, man? Dark as shit in here, bro. What the fuck
is... Once he got stuck in there.
What the...
Looks like the bottom of a glass.
Damn. Yo, my nigga. You had the worst death in history, I think, bro. Let's go back around. You had the worst fucking death. In the history of mankind, cuz. I know that shit sting like shit. Oh, I can't go down? Damn. Alright, keep going. Keep going. I tried to go all the way around, man, but it wouldn't let me. I thought it wouldn't let me. Maybe it will. Alright, I just got. Nope, that won't let me go no further. Yo, I can't even see down here. I gotta look on my. I can't even see down here. Maybe I gotta back off. I can't look to the left. What is this, like, sticking into them? I can't look at these? Or oh, those don't matter, I guess. Alright, we're about to back out of here. No, it's not letting me look at anything else.
The blood comes from the other side of the corridor and ends next to the body. He was attacked in the other room and dragged to the hall.
Damn, bro. I still think I only got fucking four on this body over here, though. Yeah, I still only got fucking four, bro. I can't see, man. This shit is dark as shit. Like, oh, there you go.
Pity he won't last till Christmas, because he'd almost pass for a tree. There's no doubt the murderer took his time.
Damn, bro. Alright. I got all five options. Go check this other room out. In yon. Bruh.
Hmm.
The evidence suggests that the events began in the lounge. How did Boccherini encounter his murderer?
How did he encounter it? How did it start? The window was bust open for one.
Did it break during the struggle, or was it already broken? What kind of person takes off a wristwatch without unfastening it?
Fucking ripped his damn...
Or fastens the strap again after taking it off?
Ripped his fucking wrist off, man. You know that.
Blood. Blood everywhere.
Shit, bro. This man got fucked up, yo. The devil entered his home.
The devil isn't welcome here!
This was opened recently.
Yo, let me drink that. You never drunk, man. This shit right here. Pull that up real quick. Alright, this is up. Shit good? That shit look clean. He alcoholic, man. New clue, though, after I drank that.
Right. Smells of whiskey.
It's a good little smell. Let's check over here. I knew this is gonna be a
glass on the floor indicates the window was broken from outside.
Absolutely. That was your clue. That motherfucker came in.
There's something under there.
Loaded gun. The pistol.
How did it wind up under there?
How many bullets it got in it? All of them.
Goddamn. Not one round fired. It must have happened fast.
Real fast. Got his ass. Let's check it. That's a lot of shit. Pistachios, my nigga. I can't look now? Oh, there you go. Wait.
What is it with Italians and olives?
Oh, olives.
They lap those things up like caviar. Like a true bachelor, he should have put these into soak. Hours of scraping to get them clean. Although at this stage, I don't think Boccherini's too worried about that.
Well, man, you know he ain't worried about this shit.
Four glasses. Two of water, two of wine.
Oh, she must have had a bitch over. Somebody was here
I've then. I've always been a whiskey man, but I know a good wine when I see one.
That Pinot Grigio.
Leftover lasagna, and it looks good. Why is it that two out of three Italian gangsters are great cooks? I'll never understand what the deal is with them and cooking. The plates and the glasses leave no room for doubt. Boccherini had company for dinner.
Obviously, he had some bitches over. Hold. Looks like I'm about to leave out. Let me look at this real quick.
One knife's missing. The biggest one.
Yeah. Where the hell at? It's probably in his fucking face. Pantry and shit.
Shut from the inside.
Alright. Some clue. Should look at this board real quick. Alright, I got some facts. I still don't have the shit on the murder. Get that mutilation. Step back out here. Go round. Look around, nigga. Look around. I can't even look over there, so. I looked at this then. He got fucked up in this room, bro.
Whatever crushed the table must have been really heavy. Or maybe it was thrown extremely hard.
Yo, I'm telling you, man. Fucking devil came in this bitch. Fucking suplexed his ass through that joint.
A perfectly circular dint, as if someone had tried to hammer in a gigantic bolt, around 4 inches in diameter.
Bro, I can't see for shit. I can see it on my computer.
Blood ran like water.
Sheesh! I missed something. God damn it, it's because I can't see. Oh, there we go.
Fingernails scratched the wood.
Sheesh!
Alright, what we got on the board?
Damn.
Still ain't got none of the mutilation. It's gonna be back in it, man. Check these walls. And then walls. Right over here.
It takes a strong man to tear that out. Or several.
There was shit in here? Fuck going on in here? How's that blood in here, though?
Jammed shut from the inside. Maybe between the two of us when Milton gets back. If I'm not mistaken, this door opens onto the same room as the locked door in the kitchen.
Okay, so that's something. Damn. There gotta be somebody else in this bitch.
Blood and some kind of sticky liquid.
The fuck was that? Yo, it's blood everywhere, bro.
Oh, shit.
Damn!
I should have stayed in my diner.
Shit, bro. Oh, fuck. I must have opened these or something. What the fuck? I know he opening them up, but it just looks gross because nothing ain't really moving it, you know what I'm saying? He just said no, though. What the fuck?
Are these teeth from the body?
Shit.
Well, at least I know why his teeth were pulled out.
Look at that! Less. And they fucking in his hand. What the fuck? Look at this shit on the wall.
What is that?
Like some sixes up there to me, cuz.
Looks like a ritual.
You know what it is,
Baccarini,
man.
Mixed up in?
Making deals with the devil? Is that, did I get the mutilation? Not yet. Damn. I gotta get in that room, cuz. Did I look at everything? Bitch. He's telling me to hit the board, but. Salt. I'm working on it, goddamn. Mutilation. I'm missing some shit. This house got fucked up, man. Can't look over here. Nope. You know it's a red car.
This car looks too classy for a forger like Baccarini. Are there sufficient reasons to believe that when the murderer attacked Baccarini, there was someone else in the house?
Of course.
The first possibility to be ruled out is that the car belonged to Baccarini.
God damn it, man. It's piling up.
Let's take a look in the glove compartment. Bingo. A man's cigarette case. OB. One of the Baccarini clan?
Alright, so it is his. Is that what we're coming to the conclusion of? I can't go nowhere else in there. Hold up. Car ain't done, cuz.
Vermont plates. Someone drove a long way.
What are we looking like? God damn it.
God damn.
Can't go over there.
Why, Lord Jesus?
That thing is lighting up, man, for me to go on this board. Can't even go no further. What do you want, board? You want me to look at the info?
How did Baccarini encounter his murderer?
Oh. Let's get back out here. I thought it was through the fucking window. Like. Yo, there's something. Somebody got dragged out of here. Well, no, I don't know. Like, there's a lot of blood in there. So, it had to... It's in that fucking room. That guy got to come back, yo. So, we can go into that room. This dude walks so fucking slow, like, he ain't got nowhere to be. Yeah, I can't even go in here. So, I got to wait for the old boy to come back. Can't look over here. Shit. Can't go upstairs. Can't look at him no more. Looking at him. How the fuck do I get out of there? I can't get out the house? Yeah. Alright, let's take some steps. Some slow steps around. Touch everything on the walls. I think I done touched everything, man. I gotta go and talk to myself. Relive the memories. We're all through this damn house, bro. Alright, so I'm stuck. This is when I be saying fuck it. I don't like when I get stuck on something. Then all through this board.
How did Boccherini encounter his murderer? How did Boccherini encounter his murderer? How did Boccherini encounter his murderer?
Alright, so that's all this was.
Maybe the body parts can shed some light on the motive. Maybe the body parts can shed some light on the motive. Maybe the body...
I looked at the body parts though, cuz.
The first possibility to be ruled out is that the car belonged to Boccherini.
Okay. There's nobody else in here. I can't get in that room. The fuck do you want me to do? God damn it. God damn it. It keep lighting up, man, telling me to go to the board, but I don't know what you want me to do, cuz. Pretty sure somebody watching this. I'm gonna have to skip ahead. Cause I'm just walking around in here. I don't know where the fuck I'm going. Is there pictures on this wall? Nope. Can't go up the steps. What the fuck? What the fuckaroo, man? Where's the old boy at, man? Hold up. Can I go to this? Nope. Can't go over here. I done did all this, man. What the fuck? So I'm not looking for pictures or something, man. Like, nothing over there. I'm pressing A everywhere. I'm pressing it everywhere, bro. I can't go around there. Like, what the fuck?
What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's back.
Oh, I gotta press these?
The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall. Boccherini's teeth were all pulled out. The murderer tore Boccherini's hands off. Hands ripped off, teeth torn out. I guess I'll have to rule out criminal intent or a personal angle. Boccherini's eyes still haven't shown up. What if I look for whatever was used to remove them?
This spoon.
A teaspoon stained with blood and some kind of sticky liquid. The mixture of sticky liquid and blood can only mean one thing.
I didn't skip it because I didn't want y'all to think I went and like Googled it or something.
Mutilations and disappearance of his eyes suggest two possible motives: psychopathy or cultist fanaticism. Which is it?
Obviously, it's cultist.
Some kind of symbol drawn in blood.
And this shit right here.
A sick altar of human flesh. Although I don't know the origin of the symbol in the bathroom and the altar of flesh and teeth, I'd say the motive was some kind of occult religion. The big question is. Who did it?
I told you already. It's the devil, bro. Right, let's get to the facts. Alright, so
pieces of glass from the window in the hall found inside the house.
Alright. So
a broken whiskey glass found in the dining room.
I knew there wasn't one.
A pistol.
Wait.
Dirty plates, glasses, and silver.
God damn it.
A door in the kitchen locked.
God damn it. So it is a broken whiskey. No, wait.
An open bottle of whiskey. A broken table, scratched. Two pools of blood.
I'm just pressing shit.
A pistol, fully loaded. I'd say Boccherini was drinking in the dining room when his assailant burst in through the window. Boccherini pulled his gun, but the murderer disarmed him before he could shoot.
He disarmed him quick as shit. Begin? Oh, the torture in there began right in there, right? Bust his ass right in there. Right.
A broken table, scratched and covered in blood.
Torture. You got this.
Two pools of blood. One on either side of the blood-stained wristwatch. With a glass broke, the bloodstains show that the murderer began to torture Boccherini on the dining table itself. That was where his hands were torn off. As a result, his wristwatch fell to the ground. How did the body reach its current position?
Lynching. Shit. How drug is that?
The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall. The lamp, torn off its brackets and blocking the stalk, Arini, already minus hands, was dragged into the hall, where the murderer used the brackets of the lamp to complete his macabre diorama.
Alright.
A car with Vermont plates. The initials OB on a cigarette case. One, it has Vermont plates. Two, it's too luxurious for a criminal of his standing. Three, the initials on the cigarette case don't match his name. The next possibility that needs to be ruled out is that the car was stolen. There should be evidence that there was someone else in the house.
Oh, that's perfect evidence.
Dirty plates, glasses, and silverware from it. The dirty dishes and glasses prove that Boccherini ate lasagna with one other person.
So who?
Was Boccherini's guest still in the house when the murderer showed up?
She must be in that room.
A door in the kitchen, locked from the inside. It opens onto the sink.
Oh, shit.
A door in the corridor, Jim. A broken whiskey glass found in the dining room.
And about
a door
this?
In the kitchen.
What the fuck?
A door in the corridor, Jim.
So is this?
What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's back.
That's the witness?
It seems clear that Boccherini and his
guest. That bitch is in that room.
The murderer took them by surprise. The real question is, what happened to the witness?
That's in the room.
Did the murderer take them?
No.
Or are they still in the house?
They're still in the house, bro.
A door in the kitchen, locked from the door in the corridor, jammed shut. One locked door could be a coincidence, but two locked doors, which open onto the same room, can't be. Either I'm completely wrong, or the witness is in that room. But I need Milton to open one of those doors.
Fuck you at, Milton. That shit didn't work.
Mr. Ness, can you open the door for me?
Press that bitch. That shit didn't work, huh? Nah, it worked, though.
It was open. Why did you ring?
I thought I should use the doorbell so I wouldn't startle you.
When I came in, I pressed the doorbell and it didn't work.
Well, in light of the facts, I deduced that it was your finger that wasn't working.
Okay.
So, what can you tell me to restore my faith in you as a detective?
What is that?
Not a good start. It's a camera, so Alphonse can see all this.
All right. Follow me. Boccherini had company for dinner. Someone from Vermont with the initials OB. Someone whose social status was a lot higher, but who was on the same side of the law. He served lasagna, and after clearing away the dishes, they opened a bottle of whiskey in the dining room. That was when the murderer burst in on them, coming through the window, which he broke with his own body weight. Boccherini, or maybe his guest, pulled a gun, but it was a waste of time.
The murderer was so fast, he was disarmed before he could fire. He focused his attention on Boccherini, totally ignoring the guest, and lifted him up into the air.
Damn!
He then threw him against the dining room table so hard that one of the glasses of whiskey was embedded in Boccherini's back. He spun around, clawing at the table, and immediately afterwards the murderer ripped off his hands.
Damn!
I have no idea how he did it, but all the evidence suggests he just pulled. Blood sprayed everywhere. The wristwatch fell to the ground. He dragged him through the corridor into the hall. He tore down the lamp, hung him from the brackets, and stabbed steel rods through his body. He skewered him on the iron bars, possibly taken from the fence outside, and pulled out his teeth one by one. Finally, he scooped out his eyes with a teaspoon.
Damn,
Boccherini must have been dead when the murderer went to the bathroom with his hands in his teeth. There, he arranged them to make an altar, weaving the fingers together and placing the teeth inside.
What the fuck?
Next, he painted something on the wall in blood, a symbol which I don't recognize, but which could have some kind of ritualistic significance. When he'd finished his artwork, he left. I don't know what he did with the eyes.
You're telling me that someone did all this armed with a teaspoon?
More or less.
And you worked all this out on your ownsome, just by looking?
More or less.
I don't know which of the two of you scares me more. Wait a second. What about the guest?
Right. Come with me.
Man, this shit long as hell. What the fuck? What are they talking about? Yo, I gotta mute this shit.
Nothing.
Turns out Mr. Untouchable isn't infallible. But you were close. Congratulations.
This must be Boccherini's office. Let's take a quick look around.
All yours.
God damn it. I just ain't jail. Holy
Jesus. There's at least $1 million here.
Mm-hmm. Boccherini's?
I'd be surprised. Probably his guests, and I doubt it was to pay Boccherini for his services. None of his forgeries are worth that much.
We taking that, right? Man, I'd take the fuck out of that. That'd be in my bank account by 5.
I have the goods for OB, but I have to take the children to school tomorrow and I can't make the meetup. Friday, same time, same place. It's signed NI.
Bro, this dude got killed horribly.
These initials are getting to be a pain in the ass, right?
I have to take the kids to school tomorrow. I don't think this is some loving divorced daddy, Milton.
I take back what I just said.
The driver's license of one John Martinson and Osmond Burke. OB.
Do we know him?
The eldest son of the richest family in Vermont, convicted rapist. He was arrested thanks to the testimony of his father, who wound up disinheriting him. He escaped from prison last week.
Of course he did.
He broke into the family home and slit the throats of all his relatives one by one, opened the safe, and got away with a fortune.
They don't make jails like they used to. All starting to add up, isn't it?
Whoa, shit!
Milton! Milton!
You're doing fine on your own, Mr. Lewis. I believe in you.
Get out!
All right, cut it out, man. Chill out. Bitch left him. Why you gonna throw him back over there with a knife at? Finish, bitch.
Get out of my way, I said! He's coming back!
Who's coming back?
Him! The monster!
The guy who killed Boccherini?
Hey, he was a monster! Well, get your hands off me, Negro!
What was he like?
Oh, you better punch his ass.
Him for me.
It was a monster. Red and black. I mean, his head reached the ceiling. He tore off his hands with his claws. It was a monster.
I told you it was the devil.
Should I hit him again?
Burke, shut up. You're Osmond Burke, right?
Yes.
Good. Now pay attention, Burke, because I have a question for you.
A note.
Who wrote this note?
Nikolai Ivankov.
Rings a bell.
One of Capone's right-hand men 20 years ago. What does this stuff about kids mean?
I don't know.
Calm down, Burke. You were going to meet up with him, right?
Yes, at the docks, berth 42, right next to where the Alligator 3 is moored.
So what's the meetup time?
Tomorrow at noon.
Get that shit out.
Tomorrow? No, it's going to be tonight.
Call that nigga up, ASAP.
Don't get too
this
comfortable.
This nigga's a fucking
we'll
monster,
be there in
bro.
No time.
Fuck. I'm going back to the diner.
There are certain types of people I don't allow in my diner. But today, I have no choice but to make an exception.
I'm afraid not, Mr. Ness. I have to take him to Alphonse.
What? Out of the question. I know his temper. He'll beat him to a pulp.
Listen, if the missing girl was your granddaughter, you wouldn't forgive me if I didn't let you see the only suspect who could lead us to her.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? Why the fuck did I have to pick anything if he had to go somewhere else anyway? I don't like that kind of shit.
Shucks.
Shucks.
The smell of stale grease was bad enough, but the stink of whiskey is even worse.
It's even worse. Even worse, master. Even worse.
Damn, this shit long. This shit long as fuck. Damn. Fucking up and shit.
Ah, Delphine.
Oh, what's happening?
Oh, thank God you're here. The lights were off, so I thought that...
I'm good. What?
I'm sorry. I got out of the hospital late, then I went to the station to pick up Jim's check, and when they told me... I'm scared.
Of what?
What are you drinking?
Bitch, you ain't tell me what you scared of.
A drop of whiskey. Just a drop.
Breathe on me. You heard me.
I breathe on you with this dick inside. Bitch.
All the times you could have picked. Did it have to be now?
What?
No. You knew.
Knew about what?
Knew about what?
What's that gun doing there?
Happy.
The guy I know is having trouble with a two-bit mafioso. He asked me to go with him, just in case. I didn't have to get it out.
Well, don't. Don't start taking on the mafia. Not now. You really don't know?
No,
bitch, I don't
if
like
you keep
this.
Up the guessing games, I'll never know.
Fuck.
He's back.
Who?
Who?
Goddamn.
Him.
Who?
I don't know why it still surprises me, but it's incredible that you were such a good detective, and yet you've never been able to understand people.
God.
Capone got out of jail.
What? Did this go back in time or something? This went back
Chief
in time.
Chief Jenkins.
Chief Jenkins? The same guy who said he was going to clean up Santa Esperanza,
I must have missed something.
In that case, you can rest assured Capone just put on his striped pajamas, and in 4 minutes' time, he'll be snoring in his cell.
Elliot, what if it's true? If he's out, what's the first thing he's going to do? Who does he hate more than anyone?
He spent almost 20 years in jail. Capone's an old man. If he gets out, at most he's going to challenge me to a race to the nearest park bench.
Please, Elliot, don't joke. You're the only part of Jim's life that I have left. If you put yourself in danger, I...
Get that shoulder, baby.
I'm fine. Thanks.
My hand? Just because I didn't use the gun doesn't mean we didn't run into problems. But nothing I couldn't handle.
What's going on, Elliot?
And I told you I'm ready to shop.
We're closed.
Can you wait outside for a couple of minutes, Milton?
Sure, of course. Although, I'm sorry to say, but we're short on time.
Elliot.
Oh, man, I wasn't even listening. I was on my phone and shit. What the fuck I just picked?
Come in, Milton, come in. Delphine, I'll tell you later. Now...
Bitch, get out of here! God damn!
You said you'd never treat me like that again. I'm glad I could confirm that you're okay.
Yeah, get that bitch out of here. We ain't fucking... I ain't seen us fuck yet. I ain't sliding the wall.
No. And it's none of your business.
Sorry to butt in.
Fuck,
I brought you
man,
a rapist costume for the party.
Fuck that shit. I ain't like all them damn questions she was doing, yo. Being all vague and shit. Tell me what
Seriously,
the fuck going on, ho.
You're not...
No, she's the wife of a friend who died in the line of duty.
Yeah,
Jim
see,
Dockers.
I ain't fucking so...
Alphonse told me about him.
Your Alphonse killed him.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Mr. Ness. Although he's not the same man he was. Anyway... Isn't a deal with marriage until death do us part?
It's not that simple. There are other factors. Dockers was my best friend. I couldn't do that to him. Not even now he's dead.
Wrestling hard.
Right. So you like her, but you don't have the nerve.
Oh yeah? What would you do?
Women have never been one of my priorities.
I'm sorry.
Forget it.
Yo, let's get down to business, man.
You
the fuck y'all talking about?
Good, didn't you?
I don't think he holds it against me this far down the line. He's a new man now, right?
Did you enjoy it?
Yes. I think it was the happiest day of my life. That bastard deserved it.
Maybe it was. Because based on what I've seen, from that day on, it went downhill. Did they find those kids?
No. How do I look?
Like the invisible man in the movie. No one's gonna buy it.
Take it easy. Everything's going to work out fine.
He looked just like that guy. I was wondering why they weren't showing him, man. I don't know why these motherfuckers gangbang here.
Relax. It's just a little further. Just follow me.
This plan is suicidal.
Damn, why he walking so slow? He won't walk.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. And may I ask why?
It's not the first time I've done a job like this. And I never was any good at getting killed.
There's a first time for everything, my friend.
Milton, if you go on contradicting me, you're not going to get into your role. Don't forget, while we're here, you're supposed to be at my beck and call.
While we're here.
Hear that? Not bad.
A white boy who likes the blues.
Blues and bullets.
What's next?
You know what it is.
You gonna let the black man vote?
Shucking and jiving, huh? Y'all just shucking and jiving. I can't go in there? Shit, I guess I gotta go straight. Excuse me, fellas. Damn, I can't get past y'all either. Oh, there we go. Apologize for my dogs in the back. They're going crazy. They out here going Bodine brazy, ain't they?
Hey,
my dog's brazy as shit.
Where do you think you're going?
Hello, friend. I've come to speak with Nikolai Ivankov. Can you help me?
Now, I'm sorry, pal. The mummy repair center is over on the other side.
Well, we tried being polite.
Kick him in the balls, honey.
It'd be my pleasure, Ed, sweetie chops.
Don't Dakota. Do that in front.
Yeah, my pleasure, Miss Dakota.
Don't do that in front of your bitch. I'm gonna try to be suave.
Listen, friend, I've had to freeze my ass off on guard duty myself. Let me and my man pass, and you can carry on warming yourself up.
The other option is for us to warm him up ourselves, Mr. Burke.
Ah, you got one of those uppity Negroes.
Fuck his ass up. Fuck his ass up.
If he's like that with me, think what he'd do with you.
What the fuck? Who the hell do you think you are?
Fuck his ass up. Fuck this,
I'm
yo.
I'm Osmond Burke.
Give me the option.
I have an appointment with your boss.
You're Burke? Why didn't you say so before? Come on here.
Man, you lucky your teeth are still in your mouth. You about to lose all this teeth. Damn, I looked down for a second. Where I supposed to go? Right? Alright. I looked down for a second. Let's see where the fuck I supposed to be going. Nigga, we ruling. Damn.
Whoa, what is that thing?
Oh, that's the devil.
You wanna know? Better off not asking.
Oh shit! Oh, that shit was opening up. I already know what's in there. That fucking monster. He sound like he upset. Come on, man, watch it now. I'm stuck on my heels. Man, I gotta work this. Bruh, why ain't no sprint button, yo? I said, nothing gonna have me walk over across that.
It's supposed to be here.
Where's the ship?
Looking for someone.
We arranged to meet Nikolai Ivankov at berth 42, but it looks like the ship isn't moored here. Has she set sail?
It isn't moored? Maybe she's sunk to the bottom of the ocean.
Shit's about to pop off. Submarine. The fucking controller twerking like a mother. Gotta be it, right? Fifth chapter. Jesus. Alright, I thought it was gonna be, I thought the episode was gonna be over a while ago. Long time ago. Because, what game was it that I played? Walking Dead, yeah, that joint, new joints is kind of short, man. It's probably like 20 minutes. I've already been playing for almost 2 hours, like 1 hour and 40 minutes. Probably been a little bit less than that if I didn't fuck up at the house looking at a dude. But this game, all right, man. I definitely want to see what happens. I definitely want to know what that fucking monster was. And I guess the beginning showed us a little bit of that. The devil got kids held hostage and shit. So. Yeah, man, hit the like button if you like the video, if you want to see the next one. I may or may not get it, I don't know. Like, I kind of want to know what's going on, but that's it, man. I'm out here. Two Man Games!
Children who behave badly, don't you? Yesterday, it was Juliet who behaved badly. Do you remember?
Uh-huh.
She hit Junior so she would finish ahead of him in the morning race. Do you know what we did to her?
Mm-mm.
Don't worry. You'll find out soon enough. Which do you prefer? The doll or the plush toy? Mickey bit Tom so he could take his food. Do you know what we did with him?
What?
Bruno
the
says
fuck?
You killed him.
I had to start my audio back up. I thought shit might be over.
Bruno says many things. Which do you prefer, blonde hair or brow?
Oh my god. They choosing what the fuck is going on, bruh? Yo, this is probably the last time I play this devil ass shit, yo.
And today, you tried to escape. Do you know what the difference is?
No.
Juliet and Mickey hurt their friends so that we would not punish them. You tried to escape, but you did not harm your friends. You even tried to help Bruno, although in the end you chose, very wisely, to save yourself. We are going to punish you. But in a different way than Juliet and Mickey. Bruno, on the other hand, did something very similar to them. He betrayed you to avoid being punished.
I'm sorry.
Which of these two drawings do you like best?
Oh my god. All right.
I'm sorry.
Oh shit. Damn. That's fucked up. Those are kids, bro. Yo, fuck this, yo. This might be the last one right here, cuz.
It's a cold day.